All right, everybody, Kyle Shepard from Outlaw Productions. We're here round six for the Flattrack Canada Racing Series at Lemington. We're at the half-mile track. Now, unfortunately, we have a little bit of bad weather holding us back here today, so we're going to wait it out and see if the rain's going to pass. This track's going to soak up a lot of the water. If it the rain does pass, the track will dry out and it will get better, but for now, we're going to go out to the pits, make our way around for some team talk. All right, race fanatics, as you can see, the rain has stopped here at Lemington Half Mile. You can hear the throttles revving and smell the gas in the air. The bikes are getting ready for the races. Stick around, because we got the Lambert race team with a team talk right after this. Okay, everybody, down here doing team talk in the pits at Lemington. I'm here with the Lambert race team, D&D. Now, you guys, tell us a little bit about your race team. You have a little bit of history running through this flat track series. How did this all get started for you?
Well, got started when he was about 5 years old, actually. We were introduced and met Gary McPherson, Don Taylor's grandfather. And Gary invited us out to his home track at the farm there, and that's where he started. Gary sponsored him a Honda 50, and away he went.
Now, did you ever do any riding yourself?
I didn't race. I wanted to. Didn't have the money. I did a lot of riding. Rode lots.
Now, tell us a little bit. I mean, having your dad running the race team, organizing everything for you, setting up the bikes, what's that like? Is it any extra pressure or is it more relaxed atmosphere?
It's more relaxing. Like, he can help me out. Like, I know what to do, but not all of it. So, he's just there to help me out, keep my spirits up, and get out there and have fun.
Well, as any father should. And, I mean, that's always a great backing to have for any race team. Now, with racing over so many years, what have you guys accomplished in that time?
We've accomplished a lot. As far as I'm concerned, he's only 14. He's won four Canadian national championships now. Now he's racing intermediate 450 at 14. Scary for me, but he's doing well.
So where do you guys see yourself going within, let's just say, the next 2 to 3 years?
2 to 3 years, I'd like to see him in the expert class. When he's ready.
Absolutely. All right, everybody. Well, that's the Lambert race team. We're here with D&D, and we hope you enjoy.
You're right.
and not wasting any time, we're going to jump into the Lemington production frame intermediate race class. Now we got, I believe it's 13 riders up here in the front lines, and we got a couple American riders, some Canadians. You can see on the inside line, that is Morgan Monroe, you know, a young American rider. She's coming out to test the waters up here in Flattrack Canada, already leading the pace. So obviously these guys are going to be dropping the gears and getting going as fast as they can around this Lemington half mile track. Now, it's been a great day. The track did dry out, and obviously a lot of the moisture's come up. It's making it kind of sticky for everyone, but also at the same time, that outside line is really soft and really loamy. But you can see coming down the front straightaway here, you got Monroe out front. I believe that's Dave Pouliot. It's sitting in second place there, and it's going to be the 112 of Cody Marionette who's sitting in third. Now the rest of the pack, they are starting to trail and fall a little bit behind, and now it's a faster pace with a lot of these American riders that come up and ride in our Canadian ranks. It's a little bit different of an atmosphere because they are a little bit more competitive down in the States, but you can see Morgan's just doing everything she can right now to hold off the front rider, Dave Pouliot, the number 16 rider, and Cody's still sitting in third there. Now we got Valley sitting in fourth spot, fifth spot's the Brody Buchan. And on the outside line there, I believe that's Darren Farrington. He's also a local rider from Wheatley. A couple other American riders in the mix here, so it's going to be a little bit hard to figure these guys' numbers out, but we're going to go on the fly here, and we're just going to keep up to date as much as we can. We got William Bellarose there on the number 17 Suzuki-looking bike, and he's doing a great job. He's not letting them get too far ahead on pace there. And right behind him is the 82 of Shane Corbeil on that Yamaha, and he's doing a great job, you know, all season long, just still running strong. Rob Churchill throwing in a little bit of a mix there. He normally rides in the vet class, and Alex Olson and Dustin Lambert, who we spoke to earlier today, he's just rounding off the end of the pack here, but, you know, he's still holding his own. An intermediate rider is definitely a much faster pace, but, you know, they're doing a great job. So you can see Dave Pouliot doing everything he can on the inside line here to try and get up and catch Morgan. But Morgan's obviously standing her own ground, doing a great job. You know, it says a lot that Morgan was really our only female rider in the intermediate class this year, doing a great job holding off Pouliot. But Pouliot's hungry, and I don't believe he's going to be letting her get too far away as we start winding down laps here. Cody Marionette, he's having a battle of his own with another local rider, Brody Buchan. And Darren and Valley, they're not too far off pace here. But we got the rider on the white bike there with the blue helmet. I'm not too sure who he is, but we're going to try and get a rider update here so we can figure out who he is. Dustin Lambert making a pass on, I believe that was Alex Olson, but you can see Pouliot driving it in hard to the outside line here. He's out in the soft stuff, so he's going to make a way cut down to the inside, and he's going to get a run at Morgan here, and Morgan's going to do everything she can to hold that line as they head back down into corner one. We're going to keep a close eye on this battle here because this is heating up. This is getting real close to becoming bar-to-bar action. And you can see Pouliot just getting sprayed with all the roost coming off of Morgan's tire. Obviously, you got to let off a bit so you can get out of that path. But Pouliot just drives it out to the outside line. He's going to make this outside line work for him here today because he's doing everything he can to get by the American rider, and which he does on the outside, out in the soft, loamy stuff, and gets a little bit of extra traction, drives it back down to the inside line there. But Morgan is not letting up. This chick has nerves of steel for keeping up in that first place position the whole time with Pouliot. You can see Valley having a little bit of traction problems there, getting a little bit sideways coming in and out, in and out. But the rest of the pack, you know, doing a great job. Everyone's kind of, everyone has a partner that they seem to be riding with. You got Corbeil here just trailing off the end, but coming back down to our first place rider, Dave Pouliot, the number 16 rider from Quebec. He's doing a great job. You've seen Pouliot doing great all season long at any events that he comes out to. He is a number one contender, definitely in the intermediate class. We'll probably see him move up to the pro ranks within the next year or two. But doing a great job as he's rounding corner three and four here for our Flattrack Canada race here in Lemington, the half mile. He's coming down. He sees the checkered flags of Mike Zalaska. He does a little fist pump, and he's excited. So we got Dave Pouliot, and that's going to be Morgan Monroe taking second spot, followed not too far off pace by Brody Buchan. But we're going to take a quick commercial break and be right back. Welcome back, race fans. We are jumping into our production frame expert race here at the Lemington Half Mile. Now we got a number of riders here.
Leading into the first corner here, we got Don Taylor. Tyler Seguin way up on the outside, trying to get some extra traction going down the back straightaway here. You know, you notice it's a little bit darker. We got an onboard camera here with Don. And yeah, we had a little bit of a race program hold up. I had a bad crash, hit the hay bales, but I'm doing okay. And we're here to announce this race, and we're going to see what happens as all the action unfolds here in our production frame expert class. Now, Don showing us some real speed and talent. These guys are driving these bikes into the corners as hard as they can. Now, a lot of people are thinking, hey, that's got to be a little bit of a smooth ride, but that's why we threw the onboard GoPro camera with Don Taylor, our number one points leader right now in the series. And, you know, this is going to give everyone a better perspective of what it is that these guys are battling when they're heading to these corners at these high speeds. And it's a high speed, of course. You're going as fast as you can go on their bike, hitting that rev limiter right before you hit the corner, and then shutting her off and getting a little sideways and then getting right back on the throttle to direct the bike right out to your exit of your corner. Now, this race is heating up, obviously. We got a couple little battles here and there. And Don Taylor just seems to be slightly pulling away from the rest of the field right now. His onboard view, we got to give a shout out to Nick Becker for setting that up. That was a great shot, great angle. And definitely you're going to get all the action brought to you by Outlaw Productions here with the Flattrack Canada Racing Series. Now, paying attention to the battle for second right now. That is the number 90 AP of Devin Profeyer. And Tyler Seguin sitting in that third spot right now. And it's definitely going to be a little bit interesting because Tyler has to get by him to make up some points here, not to let Don get too far away. Tyler's definitely driving it hard down into the inside. He's going to hopefully make a pass here shortly, but it seems to be Devin that's holding off Tyler Seguin. You know, Tyler Seguin, a great riding career. He rides for the KBR Kurt Bueger race team. He's partnered alongside with the other riders in the stable, which would be Doug and Steve B. You know, great guys to look up to. Definitely always helping out in the pits and giving great pointers, you know, to help excel any racer at any age into a higher rank for sure. Now, getting back up to with our leader here, a battle for fourth, I believe this is. And that's going to be between two American riders, Austin Luzek from New York on the number 10, leading ahead of him. Parker Norris from Flushing, Michigan, not too far off from him. And those two are going to be battling it out, obviously, because they want to see who's going to come out on top here. But we keep going back up to this battle for second, and Devin just seems to be holding his own against Tyler Seguin. And Seguin's having a little bit of trouble. Had a bike malfunction earlier in the day. Hopped onto his brother's bike, actually, so he's probably just getting accustomed to what it's like to be on his bike. But we're going to go back on board here with Don Taylor and take a nice little ride. I'm not sure about you, but to anybody watching that, that's obviously got to be a quick little adrenaline rush. Hopping on board these bikes, going at triple-digit speeds, heading down the straightaways, throwing it into the corner sideways. There is nothing more exciting and more fun with your clothes on than flat track racing here at Flat Track Canada. And be sure to get in the mix and definitely bring your bikes out. It's an easy conversion to get these bikes going. So Seguin on the number 19, because that is his brother's bike that he's hopped onto. Definitely trying to get around Devin here, but we're not sure if he's going to have enough time because we're winding down on laps here in our production frame expert class. Now, quite the little gap Don's got going on. Don's kind of rounding out of corner four right now. Those guys are just going in. Don might have a full corner lead by before this race is over on that fast-looking KTM, obviously. Doing a great job. Don's very consistent with his racing, and it definitely shows with everything that he does. So this battle for second, this is probably the most interesting part of the race right here, because Tyler knows he's winding down on laps. He's got to make some moves, and he's got to get around him to get those valuable points back, because we are winding down on our flat track season. Obviously, you know, everything comes into play with all of our teams. Everyone wants to make sure that they got that number one play before the season's done. But it's going to be a toss-up to see what else is going on here in the mix. And we got Sean Hoy, I believe. He's sitting in last place. And Don might be catching up to him. It's going to be close to see what happens with him. Nick Wensler just going down the front straightaway here. I believe Nick's number 29, but he's on a number 39 machine. He also had to switch bikes here today. But it's going to be Don Taylor who's going to be coming around here. for his final lap, and we're going to go on board with Dunn. We're going to take a nice little, I guess you could say, victory lap, as he has no one even close to him here at the Lemington Half Mile. So we're just going to sit back and enjoy the view here with Dunn as he comes around corner 3 and 4 to the final straightaway. Great job by Don Taylor, obviously taking the win here in the Production Frame Expert class, and taking that second place is Devin, and not too far off him, like within a half a bike length, is Tyler Seguin. Now Don Taylor's going to go out for a quick little victory lap. We are going to take a quick commercial break, and we're going to be right back with our open intermediate racing. Okay, welcome back, race fans, for our open intermediate race here at the Lemington Half Mile, and we are going to be going green very shortly. Off with a great start, bunch of riders heading into the first corner, a lot of people all tied up. It looks like Dave Pouliot is up out front, Brody Buchan making a little bit of a charge on the outside line there, Buchan sitting in second. Too hard to see who is running in what position right now, because we just want to get a wide angle, show you the speed that these guys are going at, and definitely it's hard to follow when you're zoomed in all the way. But it's going to be Dave Pouliot rounding off corner 4 here in first, Brody Buchan, and that's going to be the number 90 of Kyle Venkonen, another American rider, coming up here to obviously dibble-dabble in the Flat Track Canada racing. I got a good little battle going on here between two riders, and rounding off behind them, that's going to be Shane Corbeil on his framer. Definitely a little bit of a change up with Corbeil this year, switching back and forth between a framer and a DTX bike. We talked to him a little bit in Welland. He's doing a great job. He's holding his own in the points series, and definitely going to be doing what he can to get a number plate before the end of the season. I believe that's Brandon Valley on the Zeta coming by here. He's got a great looking ride there. Zeta, it's an imported bike, and you know, it's a kind of a one-off here in Canada. Not, I believe it's the only one that's used for flat track racing, but definitely a cool looking bike. Great thing to check out there. You got Dustin Lambert rounding off the end of the pack here. But Pouliot just seems to be walking away with this race right now. He's heading into corner 1. Not too far off pace is Brody Buchan. Buchan coming back from his injury from the Paris short track 8th mile. Broke his wrist. Definitely going to be coming and charging hard to get a top 3 spot here before the season's done. Brody is a very talented rider, very smooth, very consistent. And you can see here, not too far off as well, is Morgan Monroe, the American girl, coming up here, throwing on the gloves and giving some shots out to the boys here from the Flat Track Canada series. Doing a great job, and definitely says a lot to, you know, have a lot of these young riders. Majority of this class is looking in between the age group of anywhere from 14 to 16 years old. A lot of young riders that are coming out here, and that's what we like to see. We like to see a lot of young riders come out. It's a very family based sport, you know. Everyone helps out, does their jobs in the pits, and then the riders go out and they have a great time. And it's always great to see anyone come out with a big smile on their face, which we do succeed in a lot here with flat track racing. But you got Alex Olsen making his way around the outside of a rider here, and that rider is going to be Matt Epp from Kingsville, Ontario, the number 7 Honda rider. But you can see Shane Corbeil, he's definitely thrown in the mix here with a couple of the other guys. He's trying to do everything he can to make sure that not too many points get out of his grasp today here in Lemington, to definitely hold him in that points chase for the rest of the season. But Pouliot just seemed to have checked out. No one really knows where he is. He's just out flying, turning laps around this track, and definitely having a great time while he's doing it here. But we're going to try and catch up and see what's going on with our leaders here. We can see Morgan definitely knocking on the back door of another American rider, Kyle Venkonen, and, you know, not letting him get too far away either. So Morgan doing a great job running down the outside line here on the front straightaway. definitely going to be interesting to see what happens going into the corner one there. Brody Buchan starting to come out of corner two, and we're going to see what Puglia does ahead of him. I believe Puglia's already into corner three. Yes, he is. He's rounding out corner three, corner four, and then making his way back down the front straightaway here. Puglia just doing a great job, being very smooth and consistent with this race, and not letting anything throw him off his game. He's going to be catching up to lap riders here pretty soon. The battle for third is definitely heating up. These two are going to be going bar to bar pretty soon here. And coming in behind them, I believe that's the number 11 rider, Scott Hartridge from Lancaster, New York. He's doing a great job as well. William Belarose having a little bit of a traction trouble there. And Dustin Lambert, you know, he's reeling these guys in as well, too, getting some great drives going off the corners here. Alex Olsen and Brandon Vallee are just ahead of him, so it's going to be interesting to see if Lambert can put a move on him and get by him. Now that's Buchan coming out of corner two there. We got a couple of our other riders coming around the corner here, but it's Pouliot is out there in the mix here somewhere, but he's coming around to his checkered flags, and when he takes them, it's going to be Pouliot, Buchan, and then Kyle Vinkonen holding off Morgan Monroe to take that third spot here at Leamington today. So that's going to do it for our intermediate riders. Now we're going to go to a quick commercial break, and we'll be right back with our main event of the night. Okay, race fans, it is the final event of the night here in Leamington. You can see the Outlaw Production sticker down there on the number 22 rider, Tyler Seguin. And that's always good to see on the other riders there. Chris Evans right beside him. A couple of the other riders, Don Taylor on the outside, and Steve Beattie on the number 26. So we got two KBR riders in here. And Mike Skalaska is going to check the field, make sure everyone's ready to go. We're going to watch for that green light as these guys all drive into corner one. Now, right off the hop, it looks like Tyler Seguin and Don Taylor are going to be going 1-2 here. Don Taylor might have a little bit more of a drive on him. We're on board here with Tyler Seguin. We're going to be watching this race on and off here with Tyler Seguin to follow all the action here. And Tyler kind of taking a little bit different of a line. You can see Don running a little bit more on the outside, then cutting down. Tyler going a little bit middle and then coming down the inside, and Steve B making a move on the outside on the number 26. Those guys throwing it in hard. Chris Evans sitting in the fourth spot there, and I believe that is the 29 of Nick Wensler, and he's a hometown guy, you know, he wants to win here. And Tyler Seguin makes a move on the inside of Steve Beattie in the corner of 1 and 2. Beattie goes back in, drives it hard on the outside. You can see Don Taylor slowing up there on the outside. Steve Beattie slicing through the middle there, and Tyler making a move by Don. Now, that is not normal for Don. He seems to be slowing up pace there and falling off and falling back as he makes his way around the outside there. Tyler Seguin now has his sights set on Steve Beattie. Steve Beattie coming back, you know, he's a Canadian guy, rode in the AMA series, does a great job everywhere he goes, and definitely dissects every little bit of racing as he does such a great job pulling through and, you know, putting number ones up for the KBR race team here. And the rest of the field kind of making their way around here. Don Taylor seems to have just slowed right up. Maybe even pulled off the track here. Can't even see to find him. Yep, Don Taylor, he's got something going on. Either it's a bike issue or a body issue. There's something going on. We're going to have to figure out what happened with Don later on in this race. But right now, it's going to be Steve B running away with this race. And Tyler Seguin rounding off the second spot there. That's going to be great to see for Kurt and the KBR race team. You know, those guys always doing a great job, doing tons of work on the bikes. And it shows right here in this racing. As you can see, Steve Beattie's just annihilating the competition, and Tyler Seguin is sitting in a strong second spot over Chris Evans. Now, Chris Evans has been around for quite a while as well. He's a veteran racer, much like John Parker, and you know, these two, they've seen the growth of flat track racing, and it's great to still have them around. They help out all the young riders coming up through the ranks as well, too. Definitely giving a lot of pointers. But I think that if anyone wants to be learning right now, you want to be learning from this guy, the number 26, is Steve Beattie, who's just running a phenomenal race right now, not even having his leg down that much, and he's just got this serious drive going on with this KBR bike. I'd really like to know what's different about this one, but we're going to hop on board here with Tyler Seguin for a bit just to show you a little bit more race action from a first-hand point of view. Awesome to see some onboard action there with number 22, Tyler Seguin from KBR. Nick Wensler coming around the corner there, corner four. And that's going to be Austin Luzak on the number 10, battling it out with the 241 of Parker Norris. Those guys getting real close, heading into corner one, coming out of corner two. It seems to be Austin Luzak making a little bit of a move, getting a little bit of drive away from him. But where in the world is Steve Beattie as he's making his way around this track? And we're trying to count down some laps here. And you can see there comes Nick Wensler again. Chris Evans in front of him. Tyler Seguin just ahead of him, holding down the second spot. I don't know if Chris Evans is going to have enough to catch up to Seguin here. But Seguin is, he's running at least, I would have to say, an eighth of a track behind Steve Beattie, if not more, who's doing a great job just holding down his lines, being smooth, and holding that consistent throttle all the way around the track there, not letting anyone get anywhere close to him. And I believe this race is in this running order. This is how it's going to finish up, unless Nick Wensler can make a move around Chris Evans here, the number 15 rider on that Harley-Davidson. You can see the rest of the pack just kind of going into the single file motion here, all kind of falling down on that same line. Now, the middle line is it's starting to dry up really well. The outside is still soft and loamy, but that seems to be the rider's choice right now, is just kind of coming into the middle and then taking off on the inside of the exit there. Not really sure where Steve Beattie's running right now. He seems to be up on the outside, running close to those hay bales. But as he's catching up these lap riders, this might change some things up here, because that might give Tyler a chance to catch up. That looks like the number 89 of Jeff Hartridge, Scott Hartridge's brother. Both of those guys come from Lancaster, New York, doing a great job coming up and supporting the series as well. You see those guys come up to Welland quite a bit as well, too. You know, a little bit closer of a race for them. Says a lot for these guys to come all the way out to Lemington for the doubleheader weekend here at Lemington Wheatley. And we're going to be bringing you some action as the series continues. Unfortunately, we will not be covering the Wheatley event tomorrow, but we will be bringing you Woodstock in London very shortly as these races continue on. We got Steve Beattie still holding down the Ford out front, running that number 26 machine hard down the straightaways, up on the throttle really heavy, and just seems to be just floating into these corners and doing a great job holding his own up out front. Now, we are winding down on laps here, so we're going to take another chance here very shortly to hop on board with the number 22 of Tyler Seguin and just see what he does as he catches up to lap traffic here. And he's got to make his way around, but Chris Evans holding down that third spot. So on board here with Tyler Seguin. Seguin's trying to get a really hard drive out of the corner here. Put his weight to that back wheel, pop that wheel up, and just get going. Makes the pass on Jeff Hartridge and heading down into corner three and four there. But rounding off, coming down for, I believe, his final lap there is the number 26 is Steve Beattie. And it's going to be Steve Beattie with the victory if he just holds it all together here for his final lap here, the Lemington Half Mile. Doing a great job all day, looking great in practice, his heat races. And now for the main event, he's coming around corner three and four for his final lap. And it's going to be Steve Beattie with that victory. You can see he's coasting. He has nothing to worry about. But we're going to send it down to Aaron Hesmer with our top three riders of Steve Beattie, the number 26, the number 22 of Tyler Seguin, and the number 15 of Chris Evans in victory lane.
So we're here at Lemington Half Mile. Third place finisher Chris Evans. He pulled off a big third place podium for the points here, because the leader Don Taylor had to pull off. It looked like he had her. How do you feel about that, Chris, being on the top of the points now?
I don't like it to happen that way. I mean, Donnie's been the fastest so far, but that's part of racing, I suppose. Whether you have a mechanical problem or fall on your arse, or I mean, anything can happen. So, I guess Tyler and I'll take it any way we can get it.
Yeah, you certainly went through quite a few mechanical problems last year. I mean, you've been on that side of the fence. Now you're just being consistent. It looks like it's going to start working out for you. How do you feel going into tomorrow, and how do you feel going into the next round at Woodstock?
Well, tomorrow at Wheatley, I go really well there. I mean, Tyler nipped me last year in the Open final. Other than that, I don't think I've lost one for quite a few years, so I feel pretty confident about tomorrow.
Excellent. That's good when you're on top of the points, when you're confident in bringing home another win. Another podium finisher. It seems like he's been Mr. Consistency for the last couple of years. He was charging hard in that last race. You seemed to couldn't chase down Steve, but what was going through your mind when Don pulled off? He's the points leader.
Yeah, Steve, he got me, went down the straightaway, made a big gap, and we got by Don, and I'm still doing the race, and I didn't know he pulled off, so I wasn't sure if he's on the inside, outside of me, so I'm kind of taking my line, and then I kind of took a little peek and see no one was there, and I kind of set a cruise control, and my visor was fogging up like crazy from sweating, and it was impossible to see coming down the straightaway lifting my visor, but I'm happy with the second place, and everyone rode a great race.
Sounds like you were working pretty hard out there. Was the conditions tough, or was it something different, or were you working twice as hard?
No, the conditions were pretty good. The track was really nice. I enjoyed it all day. It's, you know, one of my favorite tracks. I like coming out every year, and it's just a great time coming here.
Excellent. So with the championship in sights, you might be in second place or be a contender for the championship now. Are you? What's in the back of your mind for going for the crown of the championship series?
Yeah, I really want the number one plate, but you know, we just got to take it one race at a time. Like, anything could happen, as we just seen Don pull off, and we just got to take it one race at a time and hopefully come out on top of the number one plate.
Well, it seems if you can stay on that podium, it might work out for you. Well, congratulations, Tyler, and have another good one. On the big crawling Harley Davidson, that thing roared past us lap by lap. You chase those guys down. These kids are all hungry and racing for the championship lead, and you're out having fun. What do you think of yourself pulling away?
That's it, man. It's about fun for me. And like I said, I was telling Jay earlier on, I don't care to do this week in and week out. I did that my whole life. So to come back when you get a track as cool as this and a promoter like you guys make everything fun for us, I enjoy being here. I love it. I train my ass off, not for riding motorcycles, but just for the simple fact of being in shape lately these days. And in turn, it makes it easier to ride this bike. So, Kurt here has offered me to ride a little bike. And again, I just love riding my XR750. So it's a man's bike, and you got to be in shape to ride one of these things. And I sure miss it. But it's great to ride it a couple times a year. And I'm glad it stayed together tonight.
It's a treat to watch you race this Harley. I mean, they're a big sponsor of the series. They're a big supporter of it. And it's great to see that you're supporting them as well.
You know what? I rode for Aaron. I rode for Harley Davidson for umpteen years. They were awesome to me. You know, Dealey Harley Davidson Canada has been my best sponsor through and throughout for my career. They always stood behind me. Rockies here in London, they helped out a bit too. And it's great that I can be the only one out here on a Harley and winning. So, thanks,
right,
guys.
Right on, brother. Well, it's the second time you've been out this season. You still put another podium win. All we can say is great job, and hopefully we'll see you again this season. Do you think you're going to put any more races on the calendar this year or what?
Yeah, for sure. I used to promote London, and I really liked riding that track. So I'm going to come to London and maybe see me at Woodstock. I'll flip a coin on that one and see how it goes.
Right on. Well, thanks again, Steve, and we'd love to see you out. Perfect. Congratulations. Good job.
Thanks, Flattrack Canada.
Thank you.
Well, that's it for us here from Outlaw Productions at Leamington. We're ready for a hard day of racing tomorrow, and hopefully we'll see you all out there.